I actually find that a good workout, a very good, like, you know, if I do a really hard, intense run or a sprint or a, you know, a high intensity bicycling spin class or something, that if I'm anxious or I have a, you know, like a sort of a pessimistic view of something, absolutely helps alleviate that.
Yes, absolutely. Your N of one has also been shown up in, you know, studies of exercise and studies by Eli Puterman showing that exercise actually does reduce ruminative processes.
What about exercise and meditation? So telomerase activation.
So, so these lifestyle things, and Liz and I wrote a book summarizing all of the different things we know about telomeres, from their biology and genetics to the lifestyle factors. And it's interesting. I would say that there's a pretty big literature on nutrition, exercise, sleep, showing healthier levels, longer telomeres. But of course, these are correlational. So what we really want are these intervention studies in humans. How much can we really move these things around? Is it just that they're all correlated at birth? You're born with disadvantage, you have shorter telomeres, you're less likely to do all these health behaviors. So we really need to experiment and move these things. So one study that I believe you just read, maybe just came out, was a study by Eli Puterman, who took sedentary high-stress caregivers, so men and women caring for a partner with dementia, and he had them exercise for 6 months. At the end of 6 months, their stress was lower, their telomeres were longer compared to the control group. And so that's a hint. It's, you know, it's just one study, but it's a hint that we can improve our circulating immune cell telomere length. Exactly how we don't know. Is it per cell? Is it a refreshing of naive cells in the immune system? It's very crude when we do this in humans and we look at blood. We don't know exact mechanisms, but we see telomere lengthening, and that's probably a good thing. So another study, Ashley Mason just published this. We did a weight loss trial, and we found that, first of all, no one really keeps off a lot of weight a year or two later, right? The people, the handful of people who kept off 10% of their weight a year later had telomere lengthening. So that was pretty exciting. And then we had a same thing for the people who kept at least 5% off. It was just less dramatic. So a proof of concept study, if you change your set point of weight, that's probably very good for a lot of your metabolic health, but including your telomere length. So that was pretty exciting, because there's many meta-analyses showing higher BMI, shorter telomere length. So what, can we change that? Can we move that? What is it? Is it insulin sensitivity? Is it really adiposity? I personally think, forget about weight. Don't get on the scale. Just look at your metabolic health, your levels of glucose and insulin.